What's going on everyone, Mr. here, hope you're all doing well today. Now just quickly, before we get straight into the video, I just want to say for those who do watch my channel and who came from my previous channel, I'm sorry that I haven't uploaded in a while. On my old channel, I was almost at 10,000 subscribers and, well, after such a big loss like that, my channel being terminated and everything, it kind of discourages you to keep creating, but I've been trying and I'm here today with a fix for you guys. So we've all heard about the big problems in terms of optimization for Warzone itself. Like, you literally have to do everything yourself. Otherwise, the game, in a lot of cases, will not run good, no matter what you do. Even if you have the best newest graphics card and CPU and everything like that, it just still has problems. There's been a lot of videos made on YouTube about, like, how to fix that and stuff like that, but for me, it's kind of made it a little bit better, but it's never actually fully properly fixed it, and I finally found what works for me, and I'm pretty sure it'll work for you guys too. So without further ado, if you do enjoy the video and it does help, make sure to leave a like and subscribe if you want to see more content like this and gaming content, because I don't do tutorials only. But yeah, let's get into it. So I've done a lot of extensive tests and different things like that over the last 2.5 days. That's how long it's taken me to find exactly what works for me properly and consistently. So some of the things I'm going to tell you to do right now, you've probably seen in other videos that haven't fully worked for you, but it's just generally good to do this anyway. So head straight over to search and type in battery and go to power and sleep settings. And then go up to here where it says additional power settings. So you're going to be greeted with this page right here. And if you already have a high performance plan on, then just keep it as that. But whatever you do, don't keep it on the balanced, okay? If you have high performance or whatever, make sure to choose that. You can click the drop down right here and see the additional plans. Don't go for balanced, go for high or what you know works. And for me, I'm using Adam X's power plan. Now, next thing, obviously this is quite obvious, but just in case someone might not know about it, make sure you have your graphics card drivers updated. If you have an NVIDIA card or an AMD card, just go onto their website. Yeah, that's just... it's a bit of an obvious one. Okay, the next thing is actually one you've probably seen in other videos, but they might have explained it differently or just not really had a variety of options for it. They've just told you exactly what to do. And well, everyone's PC is different, okay? So go on to start, click on documents, and you're gonna wanna go to Call of Duty Modern Warfare, players, and you have advanced options right here, ADV options. Double click that. Once that opens, you have these advanced options here. You've got video memory scale, render work account, and that's basically all that we need to know. So what I want you to do is go into your task manager, bring it up right beside the advanced options, click on performance. Now go straight to your CPU and see how many cores you have. Don't worry about the logical processors, just cores. I have 6 cores, so render work account equals 6. Once you get your render work account set to the amount of cores you have on your CPU, go down to your GPU. If you're wondering why it's like running so high right now, I'm recording at a very high bit rate usually for games, but I'm actually recording my desktop, so it's running quite high just from that itself. But go straight over here and your dedicated GPU memory usage or shared GPU memory usage. This will basically just tell you exactly how much gigabyte of VRAM you have on your card. Mine is 8 gigabyte, and that's all you need to know. I have all the values you need to input there for your video memory scale, and I'll put them on the screen right now, and you choose what works with your specs or what value you should be inputting. So if you have 8 gigabyte plus VRAM, make your video memory scale 0.85. If you have 8 gigabyte VRAM, 0.65, 6 gigabyte VRAM, 0.55, and 4 gigabyte VRAM, 0.45. And that's all you need for that. So make sure you go up here and save it, and then you can click the X and X out of it, and then right click and go to properties and check read only, press apply, and then press OK. That way, when you do load into your game, the game can't change it back to whatever it was. It's just, it has to use the values that you've input here. That way there's no messing around, nothing's gonna change. That's what it's gonna do, okay? And it's gonna work. If it doesn't work, tell me down in the comments and I'll try and help. Now, we're about to get into the settings in the game itself, but first of all, open up your Battle.net, go up to the top here, click settings, right in the app settings at the top here on game launch, set that to exit battle.net completely, I mean, and then press done. Now, launch your Warzone. So we're just gonna go over a couple of settings that I found really helped me out, and to be honest, I had to raise a couple of graphical settings rather than lower them. And that basically, for some reason, made my it made my GPU and CPU also run where it should be rather than underperforming or overperforming and causing problems. So don't worry, okay? Just come with me, I'll show you what I mean. Okay, so go over to general, then go to field of view, because field of view can affect FPS. If it's too high, there's just more for the game to render in because you have a wider field of view, therefore where you're looking it has to render. So anywhere between 90 and 110 should be okay. Otherwise, if your PC is good enough but you're still having problems, then yeah, don't worry about this stuff right now. But one thing I did find help for some reason, I don't know why, I'm guessing this should be in the graphics settings but it's not, Disabling dismemberment and gore effects for some reason helped, so I disabled that. We're not kids, we're allowed to see it, but I disabled it, and it helped. Next, we're going to go into the graphics mode. Make sure, since I'm recording, I have this on full screen borderless right now, so I can switch to my other monitor, but always keep this on full screen. Always keep that on full screen. And for your monitor, choose whichever one. Display adapter, keep that on what it is unless you have a different preference if you have two GPUs. Screen refresh rate, keep that at the highest you can get in the options. For me, I'm just on a 75Hz monitor. Render resolution, put that all the way up to 100. Your game is going to look horrible if you don't have it. If the render resolution is lower than 100, you might as well set your actual resolution lower, down to 1280 by 720, which is not what you want to do. So keep that on 100 and keep your aspect ratio 1920 by 1080 or whatever your native monitor resolution is. Aspect ratio, set that to what it is, otherwise keep automatic. VSync, obviously keep that off. Custom frame rate, I did used to go by customs because custom frame rate would seem to help with the way I was thinking, but I turned it to unlimited. If you open up a calculator, whatever frames you know you can achieve or whatever your refresh rate is, so mine's 75, so go 30% more frames than your target frame rate and set that to your custom gameplay frame rate limit. So if you have a 144Hz monitor, go on Google, type in 144 plus 30% and it'll give you an answer. And so on for other refresh rates. Otherwise, yeah, just do whatever you want there. I think these things for me were just kind of a personal preference and it seems to be working, so I don't want to change it. Display gamma, you don't really need to worry about this, but just keep it on what it already is on. I'm not going to explain these settings too much, I'm just going to tell you what works for me and what I think should be good for you, like just generally what should be good. Streaming quality, keep that on normal. Texture resolution, normal. I used to have streaming quality low, but after I changed it up to normal, it just seems to be working. It seems to be pushing my specs a little more, and that means it's running consistently and using up as much as it needs to. Texture filter, anisotropic, I keep that at high, as well as particle quality, because as I said, raising some of my graphical settings didn't lower my FPS by much, maybe 5 or 10, but I can still achieve 75 frames per second, and it just made things more consistent in terms of stability and performance. Which sounds odd, but trust me, just give it a try, okay? Bullet impact and sprays, everyone says to turn that off. I like to keep it on so I know where I've shot, or if someone's shot at me, I like to know where the bullet hit. Maybe I don't know where they shot from, it just helps me. Tessellation is just basically a beauty graphic, which you don't really need. There's not too much difference, as you can see. So you might as well turn that off. On-demand texture streaming, keep that disabled. Now you can ignore this here, go down to shadow and lighting. Shadow map resolution, I keep on normal. Cache spot shadows and cache sun shadows, keep on disabled. Some people recommend keeping them on enabled, so it doesn't have to basically cache them every time you go into the game. But it does take up extra VRAM on your graphics card, so I keep them off, and I don't find any problems. Particle lighting, normal. Obviously, ray tracing, no, unless, well, if you're just playing the campaign and you just want the best kind of visual experience, then go ahead. But for multiplayer, turn off ray tracing if you have it. Ambient occlusion, disabled. Screen space reflections, SSR, keep that on low. Now, this one is preference as well, but if you're recording, your bitrate is going to be messed up and it's going to look very pixelated if you turn anti-aliasing off, because your bitrate is going to try and figure out where all the edges are and it's going to get pixelated because it's going to get confused. So if you have some form of anti-aliasing on, then it will help with quality of recording. Obviously, as well as what you see. So I just keep that on SMAA1. Depth of field disabled. Filmic strength, keep that always off. World motion blur, weapon motion blur disabled. Film grain, I keep all that off. And just dynamic resolution, just disable that and then you don't have to worry about this one here either. Once that's disabled, this one doesn't do anything. So that's basically it. That's everything right there. Also, another way to find out how much VRAM you have, you can just go up here. Once you're in the graphics setting, it tells you. If it says 8,171, that just means you have 8 gig of VRAM. So that's basically it. Yeah, don't forget to change this to full screen. I'm just not doing it because I'm recording. So yeah, that's basically it, guys. Hopefully this does help. If you do end up having any other issues, obviously, if you do, it could be just your specs in general and you might need to upgrade when you can in the future. There's not too much you can do in this game in terms of settings to turn things down a lot to be able to play, unless you want to play on less than 720p. Or have your render resolution all the way down, which is gonna, it's not gonna be a fun experience either way. If there's anything that I didn't cover, let me know. If you have any other additional tips for people, let me know down in the comments and I'll try and pin the comment if I think it's worthy of other people knowing about. Anyway guys, hope you're all having a wonderful day and I will see you in the next video, hopefully. I'm not sure if you're gonna be here, but we'll see, I guess. Have a good one.